Okay, so we will start with scales. Now, what do you mean by scale? So we can say scale is a medium through which we can increase the dimension. We can scale is a something. Scale is a medium through which we can increase or decrease the dimension of an object. Or I can say that scale is a medium. Right. So what we do in scale, what we have plane scale. And diagonal scale. Right now we have only these two types of scale. Now this plane scale and diagonal scale. So before that we need to understand three things in this: RF, ML, and LS. What is RS? RS is representative fraction. Representative fraction. What is maximum length? Is the maximum length you required for your sum. And length of scale or scaled length is how much you want to draw. The thing what we have to draw it, that is length of scale. So what is the representative fraction? See, we need to focus on only on these three things. So first we'll take RF. What is RF? Representative fraction. So what is representative fraction? Is drawing length upon actual length. Now, what do you mean by drawing length upon actual length? I'll give you an example. Let's say if you have a T scale, and if I'm drawing this T scale, the length of this T scale is 6 centimeter, but in actual it is 60 centimeter, right? So 6 centimeter is my drawing length. Like, since I don't have that big paper, so I'm just drawing 6 centimeter long T scale. So that is my drawing length. But actual length of the T scale is how much? 60. When you check your T scale, it is almost 60 centimeter long. But what you are drawing? Only 6 centimeter. So drawing length upon actual length, that is 6 centimeter upon 60 centimeter will give you RF. So it is nothing but 1 upon 10. So this is representative fraction. Got it? Maximum length will be given to you. At times they will give you measure up to 2.3 meter. So we'll take how much? 3 meter. This I'll explain you in detail when we will solve the sum. But this will be given to you. Always remember, maximum length will be given to you. And this you need to find out. How will you find out length of scale? We have a formula. The length of scale is equal to RF into MN. So in scale, if you know 1, 2 and 3, it is done. So 1 generally you need to find out or it is given. Second will be always given to you. You don't have to assume maximum length. This will be given to you. And you have to always find out length of scale, which is RF into ML. Right? So what we will do, I will show you one sum, right? And in that we will discuss how to go about this. Just give me a minute. Okay. Now, if you see in this, what they've given? They've given construct a plane scale. Construct a plane scale of long enough to measure up to 2 meter, RF 3/40, and you show 1.8 meter and 1.2 meter on it. So first, we will find out. See, three things we required: 1, 2, and 3. RF, ML, and LS. Do we know RF in this? Yes, we know RF. How much it is? 3/40. So 3/40 is my RF. Sorted. Maximum length. How much is the maximum length? Read up to 2 meter. So maximum length is also given. Length of scale. We know the formula. That is RF into ML. How much is RF? 3 upon 40. What is maximum length? 2 meter. That is 2 into 2 meter, right? So 2 into 100 will give me centimeter. Now, why I'm doing it in centimeter? Because we have scale, which is in centimeter, right? Normally, people have scale in centimeter. That's why. So if you solve this, this is 3 upon 40 into 2 into 100. So when you do the calculation, if you do this way, you get 15 centimeter. So this is what we got, length of scale. So this is the basic calculation what we do, right? So what I will do, I will show you the same thing in my video also. I'll just give me a minute. So if you see the same calculation, right? Now, remember one thing, whatever we are doing, see this. If you see this part, I'll just do it with other color, representative fraction. All this you have to write in proper format. I'll erase all this. So I think it will be better. See. So RF, maximum length, length of scale or scale length, both are same, right? So 3 upon 40 into 2 into 100, we got 15 centimeter. Got it? So you draw 15 centimeter line and you take height 5 millimeter. Now I'm taking this height as 5 millimeter. You can take 6 millimeter. You can take 9 millimeter. You can take 15 millimeter, even if you can even take 20, 12 millimeter, whatever you want, you can take, but I'm taking 5 millimeter. So keep this in mind, right? So this is our plane scale. Now I'm dividing this because I want to mark 1.8 meter and 1.2 meter, right? So what I will do, I will draw this, then I will draw angle, see. I'll draw angle like this. Then I'll cut 1 centimeter arc, one centimeter arc. Now, how many arcs I have to cut? I have to cut only 2 arcs. Why? Because maximum length is 2 meter. If you see this, I have to cut how many times? I have to divide this line into how many parts? This block into how many parts? 2 parts. Why? Because maximum length is 2 meter. So always remember, this is very important point. You should always divide according to maximum length, right? So right now, maximum length is 2 meter. I'm dividing this into 2 parts. So now see this. Join this to this. So all of you know how to divide line into equal parts. So according to that, we can divide line into 2 parts like this. Got it? Then we'll write 0 over here, 1 over here, and we'll divide this. See, actually, if you see, this is meter, right? And this is also meter. Both are meter. But if I divide this meter into 10 parts, then it will become decimeter, right? So this is what we are trying to do over here. Now we are dividing the first block into 10 parts. Now why I'm dividing it? Because I need to mark 8 decimeter also. Na? See, it is 1.8 meter. So it is 1 meter and 0.8 meter. So 0.8 meter is nothing but 8 decimeter. Na? Right? So what we will do, we will divide this into first block into 10 parts. Like this. So that I will show you in my video how I've done it. So then you'll have an idea. Wait. See this. I'll erase this. See this.
Okay. So, sir, we draw another angle to divide the last part into 10, right?
Yes. So first angle would be 30, the other angle is 45. So I'll show you that, right? So in this, when you take first angle, you take roughly 30 degree. And when you take second angle, you take 45 degree. So that would be easier for you to remember. Always remember, when you divide this, take first angle 30 and the second angle 45 degree. Okay. And how to mark 1.2 and 1.8? That I'll show you. Now you have to mark what 1.2. So how will you mark 1.2? So if you want to mark 1.2, so I know that it is 1 meter. So this is 1 meter, see, right? And 2 decimeter, 1, 2, 2 decimeter. So this distance is 1.2 meter. If I want to mark 1.8 meter, so I'll take 1 meter and from here I will take 8. So this distance would be 1.8. So that way you can mark. I'll just show you on my video so you will have an idea of it. This is 1.2. And this is 1.8. Okay. 1.8 meter. Now there is one shading part which is not required, it is optional. But if you want to do, you can do. In that, what you have to do? You take 2 millimeter, wait, huh? Yeah. So you take 2 millimeter from up and you draw a horizontal line. And you take 2 millimeter from down and you draw a horizontal line. So you'll get line like this. Then what you have to do, then you have to take pencil and, oh, this is too thick. Then what you have to do, then you take pencil and you shade this portion, the in-between portion. It is actually 1 millimeter, so it will be easier to shade. This way you show. This is how.
And so why do we have to do this?
Okay. So why you have to do this? Because this is actually in 1700 century. This was very famous. Between 1700 to 1900 century, the scale. So that time they were very illiterate. A lot of people, they were not knowing numbers and all. So for them to explain it to them, they used to use this as a sign language. Like we have fingers on our hand, like, you know, 5 fingers, right? So they used to not, if you see any scale, won't be, it will be max 0 to 9 and this 10. So they can explain it with their hand. Sign language, say, they can explain them. So it's because of that. When you will meet me offline, that time I'll explain you. Like, ye kaise use karte hain. But this is for illiterate people. So choice is yours, whether you want to do this or you don't want to do this. This shading part. People are using it blindly. But actually, it is... वो थोड़ा कूल भी लगता है कि हाँ दिखने में अच्छा लगता है एंड ऑल बट इट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एज सच सो दैट्स व्हाई आई सेड ना इट इज ऑप्शनल सो इट्स अप टू यू इफ यू वांट टू डू इट इफ यू डोंट वांट टू डू इट
ओके
ओके सो सो ऑल ऑफ यू गॉट दिस एनी डाउट अप टिल नाउ ओवर हियर
नो सर
So in the end, it will look like this. If I'll remove, so this will be the final presentation. And what all we need to keep in mind when you are doing this? See, we need to write this and remember this. We have to write full and guideline. We need to write meter, we need to write decimeter, we need to write RF. This will carry one mark each. Okay. This division will carry 1 mark. This division will carry 1 mark. If you do it directly, then they will cut one mark. Remember that. And this you have to show this dimension that will also carry 1-1 mark. So if you want to see, this is, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 marks like this. This formula, this right answer will give you 8. This is 9. This is 10, 11. This is 12. So minimum is 12 marks. Now it depends. They may increase. They may give 1 mark over here, right? For the correct answer, 2 marks. So that way they can give marks. But roughly, this is how the marks distributions are, you know, 1, 2, 3. So generally 5 to 6 marks for the writing part. And the remaining part, remaining marks are for the scales, right? Okay, drawing this box will have 1 mark. So that way they will give marks. But remember, you need to write meter, decimeter, RF. You have to show this division. All these things keep in mind. This 30 degree, 45 degree. You don't have to write 30 degree, 45 degree. But it's only for your reference I'm writing this. So this will be our final thing. So now we have another sum, right? Now in this sum, if I'm reading this, what they've given? They've given on a map, the distance between two points is 4.5 centimeter, which represents the actual distance of 1.8 meter. Find RF and use it to construct a plane scale long enough to measure up to 4.8 meter. So we need 3 things, right? RF, maximum length, and length of scale. So RF we need to find. How we can find RF? We have a formula, drawing length upon actual length. So we can find RF. Maximum length is how much? 4.8 meter. So 4.8 meter. So what I will do, I will take this 5 meter. Always remember, we will always round off. And even if it is 4.1, I will still take 5. Always. Always round off to next higher digit, right? And LS is equal to what? RF into ML. So what we need to do, we need to find RF first. So RF is drawing length upon actual length. Now, if you read this sentence on a map, the distance between two points is 4.5 centimeter. This is something which is drawn on the map, right? Which is 4.5 centimeter and which represents the actual distance of 1.8 meter. So this is actual length. So I can say that this is 4.5 centimeter upon 1.8 meter. But wait, this is centimeter, this is meter. We can't do this. So we need to have, what I will do, I will convert this into millimeter, 45 millimeter. And I will convert this into 1800 millimeter. This will be easier, right? So 45 upon 1800 would be my RF. Maximum length is 5 meter. So 45 upon 1800 into 5 meter into 100 centimeter. So this 0000 will go 45 into 5 upon 18. So 9 twos are, 2 nines are, and 5 nines are. So this way, 25 divided by 2, 12.5. So my length of scale would be 12.5. I'll just show you in my video. So wait, let me. Yeah, we got that. I'll just erase. Got it? So if you see, yeah, so if you see this, drawing length 4.5 centimeter, actual length 1.8 meter, I have converted into centimeter, maximum length is 4.8 meter, so I took 5 meter. We should always round off. Maximum length can't be in this, you know, decimal mein nahi hoga, 4.8 nahi hoga. We should be round number only. And representative fraction is drawing length upon actual length. So RF is 1 upon 40. We can do it like this, or we can use it whatever you feel comfortable, and multiply by 5 into 100. So 500 centimeters. So you got 12.5 centimeter. Now this is a plane scale sum, right? Now how I came to know it's a plane scale sum, it is only up till 1. If you see over here, it's only up till 1 decimal point. See, it is 4.8, right? So plane scale. If it is a diagonal scale, then we'll have 4.81. So that I'll explain you when I'll explain you the difference between plane scale and diagonal scale. But right now we are doing plane scale. So this sum is in this 2 digit, 1 meter and 1 decimeter. If you're doing diagonal scale, then it will be meter, decimeter and centimeter, right? Okay. So what I need to do in this, since 12.5, so I can draw 12.5 line, 12.5 centimeter long line, I will take height 5 millimeter. As I explained previously, you can take 5, 6, 9, 12, 15, whatever you want. So I'm taking 5. Now I'll divide this into how many parts? I'll divide this according to maximum length. So this you should keep in mind. We should divide according to maximum length. Whatever the maximum length. In this case, maximum length is 5 meter. So we'll divide into 5 parts. So I'll draw this. I will draw angle. I'll cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I will divide this into 5 parts. Few people will ask me, sir, it is 12.5. Can I take 2.5, 2.5, 2.5, 2.5, 2.5? See, I don't have any issue, but this construction will carry marks. So if you do directly, you will lose this 1 or 2 marks. So I don't want you people to lose that mark. So that's why I'm not recommending you people to do this directly. Okay, that you should keep in mind. So please remember that, show construction. After that, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 10. Now we'll divide this first block into how many parts? 10 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And same way, we'll do the division. So we'll see this in video, how it is given. And this video is there on our channel. See this. We'll draw this, we'll divide it 5 parts. Then we'll write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 10. Then we'll divide, then we'll write meters, meter, decimeter, RF. We should write that. Then we'll divide the first block into 10 parts. Got it? Now, how much we have to mark over here? We have to mark 4.8 meter. So how will you mark 4.8 meter? If I want to mark 4.8, so I know this 8 wala part is here, see this. So from here to here, right? 8 from here and 4 from here. So this is 4.8 meter. So this is how we will show. Wait, I'll show you in my diagram also in the video. See. 4.8. Got it? So this is how you should show. I'll just erase all this. Yeah. So this is how it will be. And then later on, the same, the shading part. As you know, you take 2 millimeter from up, draw a line, 2 millimeter from down, you draw a line, and shade alternate block. The 0 to 1, the small one, you start shading it from there. Then you will get this alternate thingy. So this is how you'll be able to do this. Now, next important thing in scale is diagonal scale. So before going towards diagonal scale, we should know what is diagonal scale principle. So see, we can divide this line AB into 5 parts like this. But if I'll ask you to divide one smaller part, let's say I want you people to divide this part, this into 10 parts, then it is not possible, right? It is possible, but it will be time consuming. Then you can't divide this into 10 parts, this into 10 parts, this into 10 parts. It is as good as you divide this line AB into 5 parts, then I'll ask you, now you divide into 50 parts, which is not possible. Practically, it will be very time consuming. So what we will do, so we will use diagonal scale principle. According to that principle, what it says that if you have any line, you can divide this line into 10 parts. What you can do, just draw one vertical line and cut 10 equal arcs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then join this to this. See this. If this is 10, then if you draw this line, then this will be 9, then this will be 8, 7. This way, line will reduce. And finally, you will get 0. That means you have divided this line into 10 equal parts. So if you want 9 equal parts, then this. If you want 8 equal parts, then this. That way. So we'll see that in video. Just see. See this. So divide CD into 10 equal parts. Diagonal scale principle. So what we will do, we will draw one vertical line from D, we'll cut 10 equal arcs, and we'll join that last point to C. Then if you draw a line from here, see this. So let's say if CD is 10 millimeter, then this line will be 9 millimeter. See, that way. Then the other line will be 8, 7. This way it will keep on reducing it. See this. So you have divided this line into 10 equal parts. If you want 5 parts, if you want half of CD, then it will be this, the 5 ala line. So that way it would be easier for diagonal scale principle. Now how you are going to use it in your scale, diagonal scale, that I'm showing it over here. Let's say you have 2 blocks. I'll just show you. Let's say you have 2 meter line. Wait. This is 2 meter. You're divided into 2 parts. This is 1 meter. This is 1 meter. Now you have divided 1 meter into 10 parts. So this became 10 decimeter. 1 meter equals to 10 decimeter, right? So this is 10 decimeter. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 0, 1, 2, same way. So upside as well as downside, I have done equal division. Now what I have to do, if I want to use this diagonal scale principle, what I'll be doing it, I'll be joining this 0 to 1. You see, if I'll keep straight line, then it is a plane scale only. Like, you know, a few people, they will ask me that. So there is one common doubt, sir. Why we draw diagonal? Why can't we take straight line? If you take straight line, then it will be plane scale only. Then there is no difference between diagonal and plane scale. We are going for diagonal scale because we want more accurate. See, plane scale is only up till 1.2 meter, right? If I want to mark 1.2 meter, I can mark 1.2 meter over here. But if I want to mark 1.21 meter, I can't mark over here because 2 and 3 is here. I can't divide this 2 and 3 into 10 parts, right? So what I'm doing right now, I'm erasing this. Now in this, I'm joining 0 to 1. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, that way I'm doing, and I'm dividing this line into 10 parts. So when I'm doing this, in that process, I'm dividing this line, which is 1 decimeter, into 10 parts. So what I will get? I will get 1 decimeter is how many centimeter? 10 centimeter. So I'm getting 10 centimeter, 9 centimeter, 8 centimeter, 7, 6. So I'm dividing this line into 10 parts. So I'm getting centimeter as well. See, I'll show you. Wait. See. So I'm joining 0 to 1. Then I'm dividing this vertical line into 10 equal parts, right? See this, what I did 0 to 1. You need to join this line 0 to 1 and then divide this vertical line into 10 equal parts. Generally, diagonal scale height, we will take 5 centimeters. So it becomes easier to divide into 10 parts. Then you see. See this. So this will be, if this is 10, then this will be 9, 8, 7, 4, 5, 3, 2, 1, that way. So this is how we will use it. Now, this is the concept. Now, how to use this concept in diagonal scale, that I'll explain. Now, this is also a plane scale sum. I think we need to, so now this is the diagonal scale sum. How you come to know it's a diagonal scale sum? If you see over here, it's given 4.15 decimeter. If it is a plane scale sum, then they will write only 4.1. But if it is 4.15, so it's a diagonal scale, 2 decimal point. Always remember that. So now when we are doing scale, we should know 3 things, right? RF, ML, and LS, length of scale. So what is RF? RF is 3 upon 10. What is ML? Maximum length. Maximum length we need to find. It is not given over here. But what we need to draw the scale drawing. We need to draw this. So what is the maximum length in this? 4.15. Right? So this is our maximum length. Of course, we need to round off to 5 decimeter. But this is our maximum length. So we know maximum length, we know RF. So we can find out length of scale. Length of scale is equal to RF into ML. RF is how much? 3 upon 10. Maximum length is how much? 5 decimeter. So 5 into 10 centimeter. So it will be 15 centimeter. Okay. So we'll see this calculation on my video. Wait. Yeah, I'll erase all this. Yeah, now we can see this. Now what we need to do, we need to draw 15 centimeter. And now if you see, I have taken height 5 centimeter. Again, in this also, you can take whatever you want. But I'm taking this height as 5 centimeter. Why I'm taking 5 centimeter? So when I'll divide into 10 parts, that time it will be easier for me. So that's why I'm taking this height as 5 centimeter. So I got scale length, how much? 15 centimeter. I got height 5 centimeter. This is 15 centimeter. Now we'll divide this into how many parts? Always remember, we will divide according to maximum length. How much is the maximum length? 5 meter. So I will divide this into 5 parts. I will draw angle. I'll cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Join this to this. Got it? So this is how I will divide into 5 parts. Then I'll divide the first block into 10 parts. So we'll see that in video. Wait. Okay. Can you see this? I have divided into how many parts? 5 parts. Over here, we got decimeter. Over here, we got centimeter. We have to write RF. We'll write 0 from here. And we'll divide the first block into 10 parts. See this. So this way, you divide into 10 parts and you do the marking down also. You don't have to draw a straight line, but you need to mark the points because we need to divide the upper line as well as lower line into 10 parts. So once you do the upper one, you can mark the points down. Now what we need to do, according to diagonal scale principle, I need to join 0 to 1, right? So that you see. So we need to use diagonal scale principle and join 0 to 1. Then 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, 8 to 9, and 9 to 10. That way we need to do series. All these lines we need to draw. After doing this, we need to divide this 5 centimeter into 10 parts. So what I will do, I will take directly 5 millimeter and I will draw a horizontal line. See, like this. So this is millimeter. Now few people, they will have doubts, where is millimeter? So I will show you where is millimeter. So in this, this is 1 millimeter, this is 2 millimeter, this is 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter, 5 millimeter, 6 millimeter. See, the length is increasing. 7 millimeter, 8 millimeter, 9 millimeter, and this is 10 millimeter. What is 10 millimeter? 10 millimeter equals to 1 centimeter. So 10 millimeter equals to 1 centimeter. So this is 1 centimeter. This is 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 10 centimeter. What is 10 centimeter equals to 1 decimeter. So that's how we got this. Now what we need to do? Wait, I'll just erase this. So after doing this, we need to show where to mark 1.52 and 4.15. So that you see how I'm going about it. We need to write 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And after that, we'll mark the distance 1.52 and 4.15. Now, if you see, this is what I've marked is 1.52. Now, how I marked 1.52, that you see. 1 over here, right? 5 over here, right? And on this line, the line joining 5 to 6, right? This is 5 to 6, no? On that line, you go up by 2. So this is what you get is 1.52 decimeter. Let's say this is line AB. So you can write AB is 1.52 decimeter. Same way, 4.15. 4 here, 1 here. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? So this is what you get is, this is CD. This is what you get is 4.15 decimeter. So this is how you should mark 4.15. 4, 1, and the line joining 1 to 2. On that line, you go up by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's how we have to mark. Just see this on my video. I'll just do it. Now, why I'm doing this? Because I have to draw this diagram. Using this dimension, I have to draw this diagram. So that's why I'm marking this on the scale. Because it is not mentioned now to show this dimension. But why I'm doing this? Because I have to draw this diagram. See this. So AB is done. Then I will go for CD, 4.1 and then 5. Then I will use these two dimensions and I will draw this required diagram, the one which we have to draw. Wait, this diagram, the one which we have to draw. So this you can draw. Okay, now we'll take one more diagonal scale sum where RF is 1 upon 500 to show meter, decimeter, and long enough to measure up to 80 meters, right? So if I want to draw this sum, how many things? We required 3 things, right? One is RF, second is maximum length, and third is length of scale. So what is RF? RF is given 1 upon 500. So that is sorted. Maximum length is how much? 80 meters. Okay, up till now what we were doing, 8 meters, 10 meters, but now it is 80 meters. So there is some change which we will see when we will do the sum, you will come to know. And we have to mark 54.5, 35.1, 20.
Sachin, sir.
Yes.
Sachin, sir, actually I have a class. So is it okay if I can leave?
Yeah, you can leave, no problem.
Thank you, sir.
This is last sum.
Okay.
Okay. So in this, I have to mark 54.5, 35.1 and 21.8. So I'll show you how we can go about this. So we know RF and ML, so we can find out length of scale, which is 1 upon 500 into 80 into 100 centimeter. So it would be somewhere around 16 centimeter. So I know I can draw 16 centimeter line. Height is 50 millimeter. Always remember, see, 5 millimeter in plane scale, 50 millimeter in diagonal scale. It will be easier to remember. So this is diagonal scale. So I'll show you in my video. See, and in exam, you need to draw a guideline. This is how your presentation should be. You have to write full form, representative fraction. You should not write in short form only, otherwise they will cut half or one mark. So make sure that you draw guideline and you write full form, representative fraction, RF 1 upon 500, maximum length 80 meter, length of scale LS is equal to RF into ML. Once you write short form, full form, then you can use short form. Please keep this in mind. So this will help you. Then you see this. Then you do the 1 upon 500 into 80 into 100 centimeter, which is 16 centimeter. Then, yeah. So we also got 16 centimeter, and we have to show 54.5, 35.1 meter and 21.8 meter. So what I will do, I will draw a line. Wait, I need to show this way only. Yeah. So tell me in how many parts I should divide. This is my block. I'm drawing 16 centimeter. I'm taking height 5 centimeter. See this. Now I will divide according to maximum length. Now tell me, what is maximum length in this? If you see maximum length here is 80 meter. Is it possible to divide this into 80 parts? No, it is not possible. So we'll divide into how many parts? We will divide into 8 parts only. Always remember, it is not possible to divide into 80. So as soon as it goes about 10, right? See, generally there is a theory. I'll try and explain you if you can. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is a common division in scale. The moment it is 11, anything between 11 to 19, I will round off to 20. Anything between 21 to 29, I will round off to 30. Anyone between 31 to 39, I will round off to 40, the maximum length I'm talking about. And when I'm doing the division, I will divide 20 into 2 parts, 30 into 3 parts, 40 into 4 parts. So right now we have 80, so we'll divide into 8 parts. So this will always continue, 2 to 10, 2 to 10 will always continue, right? This I may explain you in detail in some other time. Right now it is not required, the logic behind this. But always remember, if it is 80 meter, we'll divide into 8 parts. Let's say in one of the sum, it is given maximum length is 58 meter. So what should I do? I should round off to 60 meter. And then I will divide into how many parts? 6 part. Got it?
Sure.
So, yeah, tell me.
So if we take 8 parts, then the scale becomes decameter, meter, and decimeter.
We'll see. Okay. So first you see what I'm doing, and then we'll discuss that part. Okay.
Okay.
So you divide this into how many parts? 8 parts, right? So that I'm showing you on my video. See, I've divided in 10 parts. Now, if you see writing wise, what I'm writing? 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. I'm not writing 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because it is 80 meter, right? So if you see what I'm doing, I'm writing 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. And this is 10. So over here, I'll be writing meter. And here also, I'll be writing meter. Both the sides, it will be meter, meter. Why? Because we are dividing this into 8 parts. What we are dividing into 8 parts? 80 meter. If I divide 80 meter into 8 parts, I will get meter, meter only, you know, on both the sides. I won't get meter, decimeter and centimeter. Because here also it will be meter. Here also it will be meter. Because I'm dividing 80 meter into 8 parts. Got it? Then I'm dividing this into 10 parts. Then I will get decimeter. So that you see. So meter, meter on both the sides. You can write METRE or ER, whatever you are comfortable. RF, representative fraction, 1 upon 500. Right? Now we'll divide the first block into 10 parts. So see, I took 45 degree angle and I'm taking 10 arcs. So I can do it with scale also like this to save time. If I don't want to use rounder, I can do it like this. And see, this is how you divide line into equal parts. If you're not sure, then you can revise the geometry concept, how to divide line into equal parts with this method. Now what we need to do, now it's thoda, see this. This is what I was explaining you. Whatever you mark up, you need to mark it down, right? So you mark all the distance, all the points down. You don't have to draw a straight line. You just need to mark points down like this. So what will happen? You will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 up as well as down. You will get this. And now according to diagonal scale principle, I will join 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. You will get. See this. See that this is too small in the sense this distance is too small. So that's why you won't be able to see that inclination. But we are doing that way. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. We are joining it. Then we'll divide this vertical line into 10 parts, 5 millimeter, and we'll draw a line. Now you can draw full also. There is no need to draw only till the first block. You can draw full line also. That is also fine. It looks neat if you draw full. So you draw all these lines. And after that, you do you need to write decimeter. So presentation is also important in this. So make sure it should be neat and clean. After that, you need to mark 21.8. So see, 21 meter, right? So we'll take 20 from here and 1 meter from here. And we'll go up by 8. So 21.8 meter. See this. Got it? This is, I'm writing 2, 4, 6, 8 for reference. Here I'm writing 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. After that, 21.8. So 21, and on that line, the line joining 1 to 2, on that line, I'll go up by 8. See this. So this point, what we got here to here, this is 21.8 meter. So 20, right? Then 1, and on this line, the line joining 1 to 2. Actually, two either an error, I think slight correction, but yeah, it should be here, you know, the line should be here when you draw it. But this is the concept, 21.8. Then you see other points also. So this is AB is 21.8 meter. Then you can write in guideline AB is so and so, CD is so and so, that way. See, like this. AB is 21.8 meter. Then 35.1. So 35, see this, 30. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then go up by 1 point. So this is 35.1. This is C. This is D. So CD is how much? 35.1. Then we have 54.5. So 54, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See this. So this is how you will show 54.5 meter. So I hope this will clear your doubt. Thank you.